Welcome to Math Adventures. Today, we will be talking about simple measurements in metric system. In this video, we will talk about units of measurement, how to choose which unit of measurement to use, and how to convert a measurement from one unit to another. Let's look at our ant friend. How long is the ant? Well, it is not very long, but how long exactly? There are different measurement systems used to measure length. In this video, we will talk about what is known as a metric system. In the metric system, the basic unit to measure for length is a meter. A meter can be divided into other equal parts, such as decimeters, centimeters, and millimeters. However, metric system was designed to be easy to use, and all units in metric system are developed from meter. We can split a meter into smaller units, thus 1 meter can be split into 10 decimeters, or 100 centimeters, or even 1,000 millimeters. Wait, if 1 meter is 10 decimeters, and 1 meter is also 100 centimeters, does it mean that 1 decimeter is equal to 10 centimeters? Yes, 1 decimeter is equal to 10 centimeters, and because there is 1,000 millimeters in a meter, that also means that 1 centimeter is equal to 10 millimeters. Because if there is 10 centimeters in a decimeter, 1 decimeter is also equal to 100 millimeters. Meters also can be grouped into a larger unit called kilometers. 1 kilometer is equal to 1,000 meters. Let's summarize what we have said so far about units of measurement. 1 centimeter is equal to 10 millimeters. 1 decimeter is equal to 10 centimeters and is also equal to 100 millimeters. 1 meter is equal to 10 decimeters, 100 centimeters, and also is equal to 1,000 millimeters. We have short forms for units, so we don't have to write every time millimeter, centimeter, decimeter, meter, or kilometer. The short form for millimeter is mm, short form for centimeter is cm, and for decimeter is dm. Short form for meter is m, and for kilometer is km. Now, when we are familiar with different types of units, we can measure the length of our ant and see when it is appropriate to use different types of units. Let's measure our ant. Which unit of measurement should we use? The ant is tiny, and the smallest unit of measurement we talked about is millimeter. That's right. We use millimeters to measure small objects. Here it is. In our example, the ant is 6 millimeters long. But what if we would like to measure a pencil? Should we use millimeter as well? We can, but the number of millimeters is going to be big. Therefore, in this case, it is better to use another unit of measurement that we talked about called centimeters. In our example, the pencil is 8 centimeters long. We can use either centimeters or decimeters to measure large objects. In our example, the height of a box is 7 decimeters or 70 centimeters. We can use meters to measure even larger objects. For example, we would measure height of a house in meters. In our example, the height of a house is 10 meters. And what about a distance between cities? For example, a distance between New York and Toronto. Very long distances we measure in kilometers. The straight line distance between New York and Toronto is 549 kilometers in our example. Let's see how we can convert one unit of measurement into a different unit of measurement. Here we have a square. A side of a square has a length of 3 meters. How much is it in decimeters? 1 meter is equal to 10 decimeters, and we have 3 meters, so 3 meters is equal to 30 decimeters. And how much is it in centimeters? 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeters, and we have 3 meters, so 3 meters in centimeters is 300 centimeters. And how much is 3 meters in millimeters? 1 meter is equal to 1,000 millimeters, and we have 3 meters, so 3 meters in millimeters is equal to 3,000 millimeters. And what is the distance between New York and Toronto in meters? 1 kilometer is equal to 1,000 meters, and in our example, the distance between New York and Toronto is 549 kilometers. So, it is 549,000 meters. Let's repeat what we have talked about today. A meter is the basic unit of measurement for length in the metric system. 1 meter can be divided into equal smaller units. 1 meter is equal to 10 decimeters. 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeters. 1 meter is equal to 1,000 millimeters. Also, 1 centimeter is equal to 10 millimeters. 1 decimeter is equal to 10 centimeters. Meters can also be grouped into larger units called kilometers. 1 kilometer is equal to 1,000 meters. We use small units like millimeters to measure small lengths, and large units like kilometers to measure large lengths. That's all for today. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe and see you soon in the next math adventure.